Welcome to Berlin, where I have Leaves Eyes with me and the new album The Sign of Dragonhead and accompanying tour, of course. How has the tour been for you guys?
Yeah, it was a great tour. We enjoyed, still going on. Some shows to come today around Berlin. And yeah, we had some great time in London, Paris, shaking a boat there. We were playing on a boat in Paris on the Seine. That's how the tour started. That's why you always keep that in mind. And yeah, we had great fun actually everywhere we played. And well, it's going quite fast. We have great bands with us, with Mayan and Almanac, and some great tour parties as well. So yeah, going fine, yeah.
Yeah, and what are your expectations now that you come back, basically back to Germany to do some shows in here?
Yeah, well, that's nice, because we have been all over the world, and Germany is the home base of Leaves Eyes. So it's great that we have the opportunity now to play more and more shows with the new album, of course, after we did three release shows already when it came out. And yeah, we're pretty happy, and I think the people appreciate it, and they say, oh, well, finally, not only in the US and Canada or festivals, we want to see you also on the club tour.
Yeah, people seem to love it, but what makes a good Leaves Eyes concert for you?
Well, I think it's everything, like the energy, the live energy, and the people jumping around, and especially when we had the new songs now, that the feedbacks are so great, right?
Yeah, I think for me it's always the audience. You know, it's the atmosphere, the energy you get back from the audience. It's always the great thing when you play live.
Okay, let's not stand on testimony. So the new album is out. It's gotten rave reviews, of course, but how would you describe it in your own words?
I think in a way it's a kind of, how you say that, I wouldn't not call it like the masterpiece of the band, but like development of the band through the years and bringing all kinds of elements to the music. We're using like folk instruments, a lot of symphonic stuff, of course. And now with Elina, we have like, let's say, a fantastic voice where we can also now try out some other things like in the past. So it feels very refreshing, and it was great fun to record everything. And yeah, I think it's a very important album for the band. Yeah, that's no doubt about that. And it was very nice that we get all these great feedbacks.
Yeah.
Is there a song in the album that has a special meaning just for you, or is there some secrets that you might have not told anybody else yet?
Maybe you want to start.
Well, for me, not so much, because I wasn't really writing the music or the lyrics. So for me, it's more like becoming the storyteller of all these great stories on the album, and it's a great way to kind of use my voice in very different ways, and it's refreshing.
Yeah, for me, there's like one song very special, because my father's family is from the area where the saga was born, is Jomsborg. And there is a Viking group nowadays, like the biggest there is in the reenactment scene. I'm a member of honor. It's also called Jomsborg. And I was just at the great gathering in Oldenburg with 500 warriors coming together, and a lot of these guys joining us on tour as well, or with their support with the music and everything, and bringing this kind of things together, like living history and Leaves Eyes and the great sagas that suits very much in the Norse mythology, always was a great inspiration for this band.
Yeah, like you said, you draw inspiration from Norse mythology, but is there some other sources of inspiration for your music?
Yeah, I mean, that's a bright field in Norse mythology in general. So, like, it's not only one theme. It's not only like we have only sagas from the Vikings or the battles. I mean, there's also like a mystical side, and we also love to write music about that. Like, we have a song called Völvar, for example, which is about strong magic women back then and their big influence on the leaders of that time, of that age. And of course, the ocean, tragic tales about that, great landscapes. It's like, you know, you paint pictures with that kind of music for the listener, and we invite the people to join the world of Leaf's Eyes.
Well, basically, you have been around for 15 years now. So, for you, what have been the most memorable moments for the band?
Wow, there are some really special moments, of course. Yeah, we played with a big Viking ship and 20 Vikings, right, at the Metal Female Voices Festival in Belgium in 2016.
Yeah.
That was a very special moment for us. It was a great show. We could bring everything together on stage, like we did on the album Sign of the Dragonhead, bring all ingredients together and make the best album we can. So I think we did with the show as well. And we have also like this big swords lighting up by fire, and it was just a magic show, I think, highlight in our career. Also, we played once, twice, actually, in Wacken. It was also always amazing in front of so many people. Or the Wave Gothic Treffen show was for you, I think, very special one. First time with Pyros.
Yeah, true.
Yeah, there are some really great memories. And of course, the first show with Elina was amazing. 21,000 people in Indonesia. And it was like the debut of Elina for Leaf's Eyes.
Yeah, there's, of course, you know, Leaf left the band, of course, and there's been some other changes in the lineup too, but, you know, you've been there for the, you know, thick and thin. So what is the essence of Leaf's Eyes that always prevails?
Yeah, the driving force was ever since that we wanted to combine, like, you know, this contrast with metal and rock music, folk, and symphonic elements on the other side. So like you create a modern soundtrack or something like that. And that's something like, you know, as I come from, you know, death metal roots with Atrocity, like this band, doing since 1985. So it was cool when this came up, like in the beginning, that we also want to do other stuff. And we did a lot of things with Atrocity in the past, like also with female vocals and stuff like that. And then to form a band, like, you know, just focusing on that whole style was a brilliant idea. Also to balance out your creativity. And that is a lot of fun. And then it's like automatically, if you have some, you know, sources, and roots from yourself, personal stuff, or also like musically challenges, I would like to call it, you know, working with a choir like London Voices, you know, Star Wars and Lord of the Rings and all these blockbusters they did, that's dreams coming true, like of a heavy metal kid.
Okay, thank you so much. I think we're gonna get a couple of Finnish questions now. So, Elina, sä oot ollut vuodesta 2016 bändin mukana, niin miten ensinnäkin päädyit bändin matkaan?
No se onkin aika mielenkiintoinen story, tai ainakin itselle oli aikamoinen semmoinen vuoristorata silloin, että mä tosiaan muutin Lontooseen 2008 ja sitten perustin oman bändin Angel Nation 2011 ja me soitettiin sitten samoilla festivaaleilla Leaf Sizen kanssa pari kertaa, jossa he kuuli mua ja sitten tavattiin ihan näin nopeasti vaan. Ja sitten sain parin muutaman kuukauden jälkeen puhelinsoiton, että tunko Saksaan. Ja mä en tiennyt, mistä oli kyse. Lensin sinne ja sitten sain kuulla, että oho, tämmöinen tapaus. Ja sitten siitä ehkä viikon kuluttua oli ensimmäinen show Indonesiassa.
Että joo, se iso show siellä. Joo.
Kyllä.
Mitäs sitten Liv lähti bändistä ja se oli varmaan iso juttu bändille. Miten sä pääsit silloin ekana vuonna sisään?
No siis se mulle vaan tää tilaisuus ojennettiin ja mä otin sen vastaan, että mä en ollut tässä niinku mukana millään tavalla heidän sitten päätöksissään, mitä oli päätetty bändin sisällä, että Liv halusi lähteä. Mutta hirveän hyvin se meni, että me tehtiin paljon keikkaa ja me oli iso Pohjois-Amerikan kiertue myöskin siinä loppuvuodesta 2016. Että tosi paljon tein jo ekana vuotena itse asiassa ja ihan loistavasti meni ja fanit ollut todella, todella kannustavia.
Joo, tuossa ei tullutkaan englanniksi kysyttyä sitä, mutta teillä on totta kai tämä periaatteessa maailmankiertue ehkä vielä kesken, mutta miten tämä loppuvuosi, niin mitä suunnitelmia, että onko jotain isoja festivaaleja ja
me ollaan, soitetaan Wackenissa elokuussa ja sitten meillä on toinen kierto tulos nyt Camelotin kanssa sitten syys-lokakuussa, eli silloin kierretään taas Eurooppaa, tullaan nyt Suomeen myöskin ekaa kertaa, mikä on tosi kiva. Mä oon nyt vaan soittanut siellä oman bändin kanssa, että kiva tullaan nyt sitten myös Leafsizen kanssa, että sitä odotellessa.
Joo, tää on ehkä vähän tylsä kysymys, mutta fanit aina haluaa tietää, että joko tehdään uutta musiikkia, vaikka se on tänä vuonna tullut totta kai levy.
No levy tuli vasta nyt niinku tammikuussa, että ei nyt ehkä ihan vielä. Mutta kyllä varmaan ideoita aina on koko ajan jokaisella. Niitä pistetään sitten, lauletaan puhelimeen ja muuta.
Yeah, just one question in English still. Fans are always ravenous for new stuff, so everybody knows the new album is just out, but how is the next album? You know, how are you gonna do that?
Are you from the record company? You wanna try to? We're happy it's out now, and it's a great album, but there are indeed some ideas. We see how we proceed, because I find it also cool to have like an EP like Fires in the North. It was cool, like something, it's not only in between, but actually that people don't have to wait so long. And it could be another idea that we do something like that. And there will be actually a tour book coming out. Also, when we play in Finland, you can get it there on the tour with Camelot when we play in autumn. So that will be a new release with some extras there and some videos and stuff like that. So and brand new songs, yeah, we will see. But I guess that will be something we're going to do now when we are back from tourings and have time, sit down and get creativity back, and when we meet again in the studio, then we're gonna work on new ideas. Yeah,
there we go.
Yeah.
So thank you so much, guys, and break a leg tonight.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Kiitoksia.